Hi, my name is David Cheseldine. I'm going to show you the features of Blackboard Collaborate, and in each case I'll show you the feature from both the moderator and the participant point of view. So to start with, I've got two browser windows open at the same Blackboard course. In the top window I'm an instructor in the course, and in the bottom window I'm a student. So let's go into the Collaborate room in each case. And as a Blackboard instructor, by default I go into the room as a moderator. And as a student, I go into the Collaborate room by default as a participant. And you can see on the surface, there's not much difference between those two interfaces. And there's the moderator getting a notification because a new participant has arrived in the room. So what can I immediately do as a participant? Well, I can raise my hand. And that could be useful, for example, if there are lots of participants and you want participants to raise their hand before using the mic so that you don't get people speaking across each other. So let's go ahead and raise my hand. The moderator gets a notification and they can lower the hand to indicate that they've noticed the raised hand, or the participant can lower the hand themselves. By default, immediately, the participant can also send chat messages and can read other people's chat messages. That all happens in the Collaborate panel over here. So if the participant wants to send a message to everyone, then they click everyone. There's the message appearing in the moderator's and everybody else's stream. And to reply, the moderator hits hi everyone and says hi Dave. The participant can also send a message to just one person in the session. To do that, they click on the attendees part of the panel. They go to the three dots icon beside the name of the participant they want to send the message to. Send a chat message. So this is a private one just to the moderator, David. Now, because the moderator is in the everyone stream, they don't immediately see the message, but they get the red dot to indicate that there's unread chat messages. And then when they go back to the main chat screen, there is the private message which they can reply to. Back as participant, this icon means is all about sharing different types of content. As a participant, by default, I can't actually share anything. But as a moderator, I've got various options. I can share a whiteboard, and by default, participants are able to draw or write in that whiteboard. So we'll stop sharing the whiteboard. Moderator can also share any open application on their computer, such as Word or Excel, etc. The moderator can also share files, and that's useful, for example, if they want to run through a PowerPoint presentation. So to do that, they click Share Files, Add Files. There's the file I want to run through. It converts it to the correct format, and once that's done, I can start sharing. I click on the first slide, and there we are. The participant can see the slide as well. The second slide is actually a poll for participants so that I can show you the polling features of Blackboard Collaborate. So to run the poll, I go back to the main share window, click on poll. This is a four choice poll. Start, participants make their selection. Once a few selections are in, I might decide to show the participants all the responses. When the poll's finished, I end polling in that way. And now let's stop sharing that file. I can also move participants into breakout rooms in groups. To do that, I click on breakout groups. I'm given two groups by default. So let's move the participant into group one and start the breakout groups. So there's the participant being told that they're now in breakout group one. I can move the participant into a different breakout group if I want to, using those controls there. move to another group, drag the participant into group two and update. And then the participant is told that they're now in breakout group two. To end breakout groups, I click this icon. And everybody comes back into the main room. The final part of the Collaborate panel is the settings menu. And that initially appears to be similar for participant and moderator. But in fact, moderator has a section called session settings, where they can enable or disable sharing audio or sharing video for all participants at once. In other words, I can prevent participants from using their mics or prevent participants from using their webcams. So let's say I wanted to run a session or part of a session without audio and video, and I would disable those, and you can see the participant gets a message that they can no longer use their mic or use their webcam. The icons have disappeared. I'll re-enable those for all participants. I can also suddenly mute the mics for all participants. So that could be useful, for example, if there's suddenly feedback and you wanted to mute all the mics. And to do that, I go to the attendees menu, click on the two dots and mute all mics. And once I've done that, I might then ask, so the icon hasn't actually disappeared this time. So I would ask each participant in turn to re-enable their audio to try and identify where the feedback problem is. And those are the features of Blackboard Collaborate that I wanted to tell you about. Thanks for watching.